It's your boy, the Hot Rodster here, and this video marks the beginning of a new series. I am creating a Quirk Registry, an official video series giving you all the information you need to know about a variety of different quirks. Since Deku is the protagonist of this series, I thought it would only be right to start with his quirk, One for All. One for All is a transferable quirk that allows its user to enhance their physical abilities. Its current user is a 16-year-old boy, Izuku Midoriya, who also goes by the hero name Deku. He got this quirk passed on to him by the former number one hero, All Might. The name of this quirk also describes its nature. It's one quirk for all people. One for all. This can be interpreted in two ways. First, as a moral duty, as in one power protects all people. This is the idea that it is the duty of the strong to protect the weak from danger. The second interpretation is the actual function of this quirk. One quirk can be transferred to all people. It doesn't matter who you are, you can hold this power. Both of these accurately describe the purpose and function of this quirk, as it was made to stop All for One, and it can be passed down from one person to another, which makes this the perfect name. Like I said in the intro, One for All is an emitter quirk that enhances the user's abilities to give them inhuman strength, speed, agility, and durability. It is a stockpiling quirk, which means the longer one possesses this ability, the stronger it gets. Since it's had multiple users, One for All is very strong now. Think of it like you're running in a relay race with a baton in your hand. When it finally comes time to pass the baton to the next runner, they start from where you left off. This is how One for All stockpiling works. One person builds up the quirk's strength and then passes it on to the next user. This means that eventually, Deku will actually become stronger than All Might, as the quirk gets stronger the longer he holds it. In order to pass this quirk on to another person, you must ingest the user's DNA. Deku did it by eating some of All Might's hair, but the transfer would have worked had he drunken All Might's blood, sweat, or tears. With this quirk, the user can choose to use this power in a single part of their body or spread it evenly throughout their entire body. The user can also choose how much power they want to output, usually by using visualization techniques. All Might had such a mastery that he was able to quickly switch between percentages whenever he needed to, but Deku did struggle a bit with this technique. We mostly see this quirk used to throw really strong punches and kicks, but it can also create wind pressure with the flick of a finger, which allows for long-range attacks. There is a lot of versatility with this quirk, and that is not all, because Deku has access to all of the previous users of One for All's quirks. I'm about to dive into some manga spoilers right now. Skip to the time on the screen to avoid hearing any spoilers for future seasons of My Hero Academia. If you are still here, then I assume that you are comfortable with hearing about some manga spoilers. Deku can use those quirks because the previous user's quirk factors have fused with One for All. So far, we know about 5 extra quirks that Deku can use. Fajin is the third user's quirk. It allows the user to build up and store energy as they move. This energy can be released in an explosive burst of speed and power. Danger Sense is the fourth user's quirk. It allows the user to detect nearby threats. It's kind of like Spider-Man's Spider Sense. Black Whip is the fifth user's quirk, and it allows the user to produce black whips that can be used for long-range grappling, amongst other things. Smoke Screen is the sixth user's quirk, and it allows the user to generate thick clouds of smoke from their body. It can also be used to cover and obscure people's vision. Float is the seventh user's quirk, and allows the user to levitate. The 8th and the 9th users were both quirkless, so they don't have a quirk factor to mix in with One for All. And the 2nd user's quirk is still a mystery at the time I am making this entry. With all of these quirks, Deku can mimic 100% of All Might's power without actually needing to use 100% of One for All. By combining Fajin, Black Whip, and the basic One for All at 45%, Deku can create a Fox 100%. A downside of having this quirk is that it shortens the user's lifespan. There is no exact calculation of how much it gets shortened, but Hikage, the 4th user, received One for All at 24, then died of old age at 40. However, this quirk does not shorten the lifespan of users who are quirkless prior to obtaining One for All. One for All also carries the echoes of the consciousness of the previous users. It has a subconscious realm where the previous users can manifest. Deku can freely communicate with all of the users inside of his subconscious. This ends the manga spoiler section of this video. The biggest weakness of this quirk is that in order to use it properly, you need to have the right body. If the body isn't strong enough, it will be destroyed by One For All's tremendous power. Deku is pretty ripped, and even he can't use One For All at 100% without breaking his bones. Not to mention, to perform a lot of the techniques, you'll need a lot of visual training and finesse. It looks like a simple quirk, but a lot of work actually goes into using it. The history of this quirk is quite interesting. One For All used to be a useless quirk that did absolutely nothing. It was so useless that the first user didn't even realize he had a quirk. Then his brother, All For One, gave him a simple stockpile quirk, and it fused with One For All. The first user vowed to use this quirk to stop his brother, as it was the only one who could stand up to him. It got passed down multiple times, and now it is in the capable hands of Izuku Midoriya. A miscellaneous fact about this quirk: One For All did not create All Might's muscular form. All Might's muscular form is actually just what his body looked like before his career-ending fight with All For One. He was then reduced to a weakened state, and he can now only achieve his muscular state by flexing really hard. He described it saying it was like keeping your gut sucked in. Although One For All didn't give All Might that form, it does help him maintain it. One For All gives him the strength and durability to flex for a longer period of time, and therefore use his muscular state for a longer period of time. And a truly useless fact is that according to All Might, in order to activate One For All, the user must clench their buttocks and scream SMASH within their heart. Essentially, One For All is definitely one of the strongest quirks out there, and it is only really rivaled by All For One. The biggest problem with this quirk is that if you do not have the right kind of body, then you will not be able to use this quirk to its fullest potential. The average everyday person would definitely die if they tried to use this power, but that only goes to show how amazing the users of this quirk actually are. And with that, I think we can officially commit One For All to the quirk registry. Thank you for watching this video. If you liked it, be sure to leave a like and to subscribe to see more Quirk Registry entries in the future. This has been the Hot Rodster. I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.